September looking to end in the green. We are recovering, albeit slowly. Our economy growing by 1.7%. Yes, that GDP number is better than expected, but it shows recovery is losing speed.
First-time applicants for jobless benefits down 16,000 to 453,000. That's still too high, though. And really, we've been in that range for about the last 6 months.
Also newsworthy this afternoon, McDonald's warning it could drop health insurance on 30,000 workers because of new health care regulations.
So all this data and the state of Rhode Island going from deficit to surplus. How'd they do that? Governor Don Carcieri will tell us coming up.
But first, stocks.
Costing, isn't it? We've been getting in all different types of economic news. We did get in Chicago PMI numbers. We've had about 170-point range today, which is a little bigger than what we've had lately. As far as had to cut their share view. So you can see now Whirlpool off of its lows, down about 0.5%. So that's the action we've had here. Phil Flynn, over to you in those hot commodity pits.
New York street signs getting a very expensive makeover. Currently, most signs are all displayed in uppercase lettering. That's ridiculous. That's got to change, right?
Did you ever notice a difference?
Oh, it's terrible. I can't read them.
Signs. I think you just need glasses.
The Federal Highway Administration says per sign, the project could cost the state $27.6 million. Your taxpayers' dollars at work. The project should be done by 2018.
All right.
I mean, it's unbelievable.
Well, you know what they think of to improve things, but we'll see. I was looking at the different signs. I don't see a big difference.
Probably won't be doing it in Rhode Island, I'm guessing, because they have a budget surplus. They don't do stupid stuff like that.
Okay, well, with unemployment at a 26-year high and unstable housing market and consumer confidence at its lowest level in 7 months, the fight for your dollars has never been more brutal among companies.
The battle, however, is leading some companies to push the envelope in order to grab the consumer's attention. The dilemma facing ad agencies and marketing departments: do provocative photos, free beer giveaways, and ads affixed to body parts actually sell products? With us now is Robert Pasico.
Okay, ad, let's pop it up there so folks can see it again. I mean, it's quite provocative. Is this
on Billboard? Apple. Mm-hmm. Apple does it, right? And Ralph Lauren. Ralph Lauren has created the image. It's consistent. It sells product. You look at the insurance category, progressive.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank
You're
you.
Very welcome.
Robert Pasikoff, always good to chat with you. All right, gold right now.
Of 1 point as people take some profits.
Mm-hmm.
Off this
end of the third quarter, we've had such a great month, as you mentioned, up about 9 to 10% on the S&P 500. So, as my father always said, better than a sharp stick in the eye. But then again, just about everything is better than a sharp stick in the eye. So,
the Wall Street Journal reporting today, McDonald's could drop health care benefits for nearly 30,000 of its hourly restaurant workers.
That's right. And while McDonald's is calling the story purely speculative, it has many wondering if the fast food giant's move indicates more unrest over the health care overhaul to come. Our very own Adam Shapiro is following the story. Shat. Tracy Burns actually brought this up to me earlier today. They're really talking about it's prohibitive to their carrier. McDonald's is saying, look, we've looked at our relationship with our insurance carrier, and our insurance carrier isn't going to be able to offer that to us,
right,
more so than McDonald's.
Thanks.
Yep.
All right. It seems places like McDonald's are appealing more and more to the wealthy. The wealthy. According to American Express, for sure.
So the study also shows that the ultra affluent increased spending on fine dining by 12% and business class plane tickets by 114%. Wow. Also on the rise, cruises, car rentals, and luxury hotels. Maybe some leading indicators that things, we're talking about GDP and an expansion rate, bringing it all home to the economy, that things are looking a little better.
Soon the rest of us might start spending on those things.
Well, I was thinking, reading that story, that I shouldn't be offended that you just wanted to take me to McDonald's for lunch.
That's you should. So from now on, why don't you accept that instead of as a gift horse in the mouth? Just accept it as me taking you.
All right,
you
Big Macs for lunch today, folks. Mm-hmm. On Chris.
Carnegie Deli. Carnegie Deli. We're going to McDonald's, chaps.
Well, the people have spoken, and now it's the government's turn.
We'll tell you about the plan.